Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students. So dear class 11th students, today once again I am here with the lecture number 13th of the class 11th biology. In the last video, we have completed the different characteristics of the organism which belongs to the different kingdom, like kingdom Monera, kingdom Plantae, kingdom Animalia, kingdom Fungi and kingdom Protista. It means in that five types of the kingdom, what kind of the organism we have to place, we have discussed. So today, dear student, we will discuss the next topic of the same chapter, that is the chapter number 2, biological classification, and today is the lecture number 14th. So dear students, today I will tell you about the classification of fungi. Classification of fungi. You know very well, the fungi are the organisms which are placed into the kingdom fungi. A separate kingdom is given for the non-green plants, that is the achlorophyllous plant, that is called the kingdom fungi. So today we will discuss about that, how the fungi are categorized into the different groups. So dear students, regularly be updated yourself that from the videos which are given on the YouTube channel, that is the Golden Flower Palia. We are giving you the videos on YouTube and the prepare the notes with the PDF files which are given in your WhatsApp group. So dear students, the classification of fungi means fungi are classified or differentiated into the four groups: phycomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. What are these? These are the four groups of four categorization of the kingdom fungi. Means the fungus are differentiated and they are grouped into the different according to their need, according to their characteristics. First is the phycomycetes. Listen, what was one thing? Mycete word is especially used for the fungus, because you know very well, in the last video we have discussed the structure of the fungus. The fungus of the structures are called the mycelium. So this word is originated from the same point, that is called the mycelium, that is called mycete. So mycete's word is especially used for the fungus, for the fungus. Now phycomycetes we will discuss, found in aquatic habitats. Mostly organism which belongs to the fungus, or mostly fungus which belongs to the phycomycetes, mostly are the in aquatic habitats. Means they are present on the damp places. You can say they are present on the damp places. Damp places means moist conditions. Damp places means moist conditions. Means these fungus are placed into the damp places. These fungus are found in the damp places, are the moist places, that is called the aquatic habitat. Second one is the obligate parasites on plants. Obligate parasites on plants means, so obligate parasites means, obligate means if they are not getting the nutrition from anywhere, any other organism, then they have to depend on the parasites. But the obligate parasites examples are very few. The mycelium is aseptate and cenocytic. The mycelium is aseptate. If you will recall your memory, in the last video we have discussed that the hyphae or the mycelium of the fungus are just like this. The structure of the fungus we have discussed in the last video. So in the hyphae, if these bands are present, so they are called septate. They are called septate and cenocytic. Septate means these bands are present, and cenocytic means the different nucleus are present. Aseptate means when the mycelium or hyphae are without band and the nucleus are mixed in the cytoplasm. So this type of the myceliums are hyphae are called the aseptate. Asexual reproduction by zoospores and aplanospores. You know very well about the fungus. The fungus always reproduce by the spores. The fungus always reproduce by the spores. So due to the presence of the spores are of zoospores which are motile. Motile means they can move from one place to another place. They have the flagellum. Second one is the aplanospores. Aplanospores are also the another type of the spores which are helpful in the reproduction. The fungus always reproduce by the spores. Gametes are isogamous or anisogamous. Isogamous means mostly in fungus asexual reproduction takes place. But if simple kind of the sexual reproduction takes place, then what happens? The two fungus are reach to each other. Okay, they will come into the contact of each other and they will share with the genetic material. So if the gametes are different types, just for example, if the spores are like this, okay, these are the zoospores and they are fused with like this. So in the gametes which have the flagella, they are called the zoospores, okay, and in which the flagella are not present, it means they are non-motile, then they are considered as female gamete or female spore. Obviously, the broad categorization is not given in the fungus because these are the simple kinds of the plant, but just only for the exchange of the material. If the spores are of similar type, they are called isogamous. If the similar gametes are fused, similar spores are fusing, they are called isogamous, and different structural gametes are fusing together, they are called anisogamous. The examples are mucor. Mucor is a fungus which develops on the pickles. Rhizopus, it is called the bread mold fungus. Bread mold because it mostly develops on bread and boiled rice. Albugo is a parasite on mustard. So these were the few points. Their points may be many more, but the few main points I have written here. Second group of the fungus are ascomycetes. Ascomycetes means their name is given for the fungus ascomycetes because they have the sac-like structure. Due to the presence, they are called commonly called sac fungi. Mostly multicellular. Mostly fungus belongs to the ascomycetes are the multicellular. The example is the penicillium. But few are rarely examples we are having, that is the unicellular, but that is called ascomycete. The example is yeast. Nutrition is saprophytic, decomposers, parasitic. Means they can have the nutrition. Saprophytic means they obtain the nutrition from the dead and decaying matter. Mostly are decomposers. Mostly are decomposers means they convert, they break down the complex unit into the simple unit. That is why they are called the decomposers. Parasitic means when the ascomycetes are obtaining their food from other living organism, that is called the parasitic type of nutrition. Now second one is the mycelium is branched and septate. Now here the categorization, here the mycelium is aseptate, but here the myceliums are septate. Here the myceliums are septate and sinocytic. Asexual reproduction by conidia. Now what are the conidia? When you will study the fungus in detail form, the conidias are the special type of the structures. Just like the budding. So especially these types of the structures are called conidia. So fungus which belongs to the ascomycetes are reproduced by the conidia formation. The example is Aspergillus. Now the next group of the kingdom fungi, the next group of the fungus is the Basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes, the organism which the fungus which belongs to the group Basidiomycetes, commonly called mushrooms, bracket fungi, are puffballs. They grow in soil, on logs and on plants as parasites. Means they found in the soil and they grow on log. Log means wood log. लकड़ी के बड़े बड़े पीसेस के ऊपर दे डेवलप देयर ग्रोथ एंड दे ग्रो इन सॉइल ऑन लेग्स एंड ऑन प्लांट्स एज पैरासाइट्स. रिप्रोडक्शन बाय वेजिटेटिव फ्रेगमेंटेशन मींस द फंगस व्हिच बिलोंग्स टू द बेसिडियोमाइसीट्स दे रिप्रोड्यूस बाय द वेजिटेटिव टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. यू हैव स्टडीड इन द क्लास 10 एंड वेजिटेटिव टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन आउट ऑफ दैट it follows the fragmentation process. Plasmogamy occurs. Plasmogamy occurs means when two fungus are coming together, so they exchange their protoplasm. For example, if it is the fungus, okay, so they exchange their protoplasm. So due to the mixing of the protoplasm, this is called the plasmogamy. Now basidiospores are produced on basidium. The spores are categorized. You know very well that all fungus are reproduced by the formation of the spores, but the spores are named and categorize according to their different structures. So basidiospores, aplanospores, zoospores. Okay, so what are these? So basidiospores are the fruiting bodies, or you can say they are the cells for the reproduction in the basidiomycetes fungus. The examples agaricus. Agaricus means mushroom. It is the edible mushroom. You commonly eat in your diet, that is called the agaricus or mushroom. It is a very common fungus which belongs to the basidiomycetes. All kinds of the mushrooms are not edible because some of them are very very poisonous, but few are edible. Out of them, one of them is agaricus. Now deuteromycetes. This is the fourth group of kingdom fungi, commonly called imperfect fungi, because the fungus in these groups are not well developed. Means if the fungus are categorized according to their function, so that the fungus will be kept into the ascomycetes, basidiomycetes. But when the structures of the fungus are not identified with the other group, till that we have to keep the fungus in this one, that is called the deuteromycetes, commonly called imperfect fungi. Reproduction only vegetative phase are known. If the sexual phase will be formed, then they will be categorized into the ascomycetes or the basidiomycetes. Now reproduction by conidia. As you know very well, conidia are the special cells which are helpful in the reproduction of the fungus. So the reproduction by the conidia, and mostly are decomposers. Few are parasites and saprophytes. As you know very well, decomposers means those all of fungus considered as the saprophytes, saprotrophs, but few fungus out of them are especially called the decomposers, because they decompose the organic material into simple substances, or you can say the complex unit into the simple units. That is why it is considered as the mostly are decomposers, few are parasites and saprophytes. The example is Alternaria. Okay, hope this topic is clear to you. Dear student, this is the classification of fungus. When we have started the classification of organism, then the organisms are classified into the five groups: kingdom Monera, kingdom Protista, kingdom Fungi, kingdom Plantae, kingdom Animalia. But we are discussing today the kingdom Fungi, means the classification of fungi. The fungus are categorized into the four groups: phycomycetes, basidiomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. So for today, this is the topic. In the next coming video, I will discuss with the next topic to you. Till that, have the more practice. Keep working. All the best. God bless you.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.